than the duty of a majority to challenge the position of the government of the day. It is also their right to test the confidence of the house in the government if they think that the circumstance warrants it. I mean, no complain about that, but when the windy rhetoric of right-thorn member of Strock has blown away, what are their real reasons for bringing this motion before the house? There were no alternative policies, just lot of disappointment opaque words. It cannot be a complaint about Britain standing in the world. That is desirably high, not least because of our contribution to ending Cold War and to spread democracy to Eastern Europe and Soviet Union. Achievement that was celebrated at the historic meeting in Paris from which I returned yesterday. It cannot be the nation finance we are repaying debts, including the debts run up off by the Laborist Party. It cannot be the government inability to carry forward their program for the year ahead. This was announced in the general speech on November 7. We carried that debate by a majority of 108. The opposition real reason is the leadership election for the Conservation Party, which is a democratic election according to the rules which have been public acknowledged for many years. One member, one vote. That is far cry from the way in which the Labour Party does these things. Two in very votes, five. For its leaders and cast by the trade union bloc votes, which have a bigger say than Labour members in the decision, precious little democracy there. The real issue to be decided by my right horn and horn's friends is how best to build on the achievement of 1980s, how to carry conservative policies forward through the 1990s, and how to add the three general elections victory a fourth, which we shall surely win. 11 years ago, we rescued Britain from the precarious state of which socialism has brought it. I remind the House that under socialism, this country had come to such a pass of the knuckle-hand-drop of our most able and distinguished ambassador felt compelled to write in a famous dispatch, a copy of which found its way into the Economist, the following words: we talk of ourselves without shame as being one of the less prosperous countries of Europe. The program is for the foreseeable future.